Hey everyone, Paul the Sound Guy, product specialist at Shure, and we're on the stage today to show you how to set up your first wireless system and how to maximize its performance in this environment. Let's get to it. Before we start, if you haven't purchased your first wireless system yet, then I highly recommend you go to the Shure Wireless Frequency Finder. Here you can do searches in your town, city, or state to see which frequency band will give you the most available channels in your area of performance. Always plan for a few more channels than you need so that you have backup frequencies to avoid interference. So you got your first wireless system, taken it out of the box. Hopefully you looked at the user guide or watched a video like this on YouTube, and you're ready to go. Your first inclination might be to set up the wireless receiver as close to you as possible, on the floor next to your stand or stage monitor, and if you're connecting the system to a pedal board, this is the most obvious place. For other scenarios like vocals or instruments, this might not be the best position. It depends on your environment, but placing the receiver on the stage floor might result in some signal loss as you venture into the venue or crowd, or getting stepped on before, during, or after the show, or some spilled drink. A better alternative location is upstage or side stage on an amp or rack. This puts the receiver out of harm's way, creates more distance for transmission, and helps improve line of sight if you're going to venture off stage. One last option is putting the receiver at front of house. If your sound person has available space in a position that improves line of sight, you might ask if you can place your wireless system directly at the console. Once you've found the ideal position for your wireless system, you'll want to perform a proper scan to find the best frequencies. Whether you're gigging around your city or touring around the country, we always recommend that you perform a group scan every time you use your system to make sure you're using the best available channels. If interference pops up, performing a new channel scan will help you find the next available channel on your receiver. First, make sure all of your wireless transmitters are turned off. On the receiver, press and release the group button. The receiver automatically scans all of the available groups and channels and selects the best group for your area. If you need to change channels later, press and release the channel button to find the next available channel in your group. Finally, you'll need to turn the transmitter on and change the group and channel to match the receiver. The last thing you want to do with your system is make proper gain adjustments. Every wireless system defaults to a specific gain setting, which might be too low or too high for your instrument or voice. Once the transmitter and receiver are synced, perform a sound check with your system and adjust the gain on your receiver to ensure you aren't clipping it and delivering optimal performance to your audio console. Then adjust your console preamp as needed. When it comes to IEM systems, all of the same considerations we explored for our microphone system relate to our wireless IEM system. Distance is your friend with IEM systems, so it's best for them to be positioned upstage, side stage, or at front of house. When you're positioning the IEM system, you also want to make sure it's not right next to the wireless microphone system, as it can create interference. It's best to keep a few feet of distance between IEM transmitters and wireless microphone receivers, unless you're using a remote directional antenna. Once you find the optimal placement for your IEM transmitter, make sure it's turned off, because we'll do our frequency scan with the receiver pack. Turn on your receiver pack and perform a group scan to find the best available channels. Press and hold the scan button on the pack. The pack will scan all of the available groups to find the group with the most available channels. Once it completes the scan, press and release the scan button to find the best available channel within that selected group. Then turn on the transmitter and sync it with your receiver pack. Lastly, make sure the signal feeding the transmitter from the console is optimal by adjusting the input gain on your transmitter. This ensures you're getting the best signal possible. That's it. I hope you learned something new and useful on how to maximize your wireless system's performance and range. Make sure to check out more content like this on our Shure Creators page for lots of helpful tips and tricks. Thanks for watching.